Yes, indeed, folks. We're coming into the last section of the show now, and it goes by the name of...
It's the illusion of choice.
Casper says he hates you, and he hates your family. Now, the illusion of choice this week, I have chosen... Yes, I've given you the illusion of choice. Nice little short topic from Joe Remy, and he says this. You just mentioned RPing on war. What's your stance on WoW's RP community and the like? Oh, dear. Yeah, it's funny, actually, because a long time ago, I think it was back when we were doing Epic, there was a rumor floating around. It was either Epic or Blue Please, I can't remember which. It might have been Blue Please, yeah, it was. Some of the RP community got very, very angry at me, I think, back in Season 1 of Blue Please, because I said something not so nice about them or whatever, and really they actually misinterpreted the entire thing. Now, back in the day, I actually called RPing pretty much pointless in World of Warcraft, and I would like to give you the reasons for that, because those reasons have not actually changed in any way, shape, or form. Now, the problem with RPing in World of Warcraft, there are two problems with RPing in World of Warcraft. One, you have an entirely static universe that you cannot change in any way, shape, or form. RPing in a world whereby, you know, you see the same boss being killed over and over and over again, and where the same quests are being done over and over and over again, and nothing changes day in, day out, and everything's a static set piece, is difficult. You know, it's difficult to suspend your disbelief. You know, doing that on its own is tricky. RPing and doing that, that is difficult. You know, do any of you guys really dispute that? That it's not actually a pretty harsh concept? No, in and of itself, it's actually a pretty harsh concept. The idea of RPing within such a static world. Now, that's not really the biggest problem I've got with it, because you can still do it, and more power to the people that do it, and definitely more power to the people that do it well. The problem I've got with it is the fact that Blizzard does not enforce its RP policy by any stretch of the imagination. And for me, this is absolutely unforgivable. You know, for a game that supposedly fosters and nurtures all of these different playstyles and is trying to be all things to all men, the fact that they do not protect the RP servers from people who would seek to ruin other people's enjoyment is ridiculous and is absolutely unacceptable. You know? To me, if you're going to write an RP policy and then not enforce it, then I would ask you this. Why did you write it at all? You know, why did you actually write it? You know, really? If you're not going to enforce it, why even bother? You know, why bother just even naming something an RP server? Because to me, that is not RP, but a giant painted bullseye on the side of whatever server you happen to be to attract innumerable trolls and people who seek to grief and annoy other people. You know? Some people roll on RP servers for the reason that, oh, they're just a little bit nicer. They have no intention of actually RPing, it's just, they're just a little bit nicer. You know what? You people make me sick. You know, you really do. I don't care if you're rolling on there for, you know, because it's a little bit nicer. Even if you don't intend to troll it, you know, it's an RP environment. If you see somebody jumping around and running around all over the place and talking out of character in public channels and in speech and in yells and stuff like that, then yeah, that is ruining somebody else's immersion. And usually, on a normal server, I wouldn't give two hoots about that. You know, I don't care if somebody's jumping around on a normal server, you know, it doesn't matter. You know, we're not RPing. But on an RP server, you are expected to at least make an effort. You know, that doesn't mean that you have to come up with a massive character backstory and stay in character 100% of the time and make sure they don't make even one false move, as some of the RP elitists might have you believe. It's like, you are not RP enough. You are not hardcore enough for this RP server. You know, that's not the case. Well, the case and the fact of the matter is that you have to at least try not to ruin everyone else's game. You know, really. And you might say, well, Total Biscuit, is it really ruining it? It's like, well, yes! You know, why did these original guys roll on the RP server in the first place? Because they want to get away from people like you. They don't want you bouncing all over the place. They don't want you standing on top of the mailbox, running all over the place, spamming rubbish about Chuck Norris and crap like that. You know, they don't want that. That's why they're not playing on a normal server. If they did want that, and they weren't bothered by that, they would play on a normal server. They rolled an RP for one specific reason, because they wanted to RP and wanted to be in an environment where other people RP'd as well. Now, I'm hoping that Warhammer does a little bit of a better job with this, and I hope that they actually come down on it, but it just seems to me that, I've said this once before, actually, a couple of shows back, the whole remark that Blizzard needs to grow a pair and stop trying to cater to everyone and actually put their foot down on a few things. With the recent change, of course, that I mentioned earlier, of the transfer from PvE to PvP, it seems that, yeah, while it has its uses, it's another concession. And you know what? If you keep compromising, you won't have a leg to stand on by the end of it. You will compromise away everything that makes you unique. You know, it's like any person. You know, if they keep compromising on what they believe, eventually there will be nothing left of their original beliefs. They will have been taken over by the beliefs of everyone around them that they are compromising in order to please. Don't try and please people. Because if you try and please people all of the time, then they will become a little bit expectant. And they will get a complex of entitlement, and that isn't a good thing. We already have enough of entitlement complex in the WoW community as it is. It's disgusting. It's disgraceful, the amount of people that think that they can demand various things from Blizzard and all that kind of thing, and think that, hey, you know, I deserve these epics, and, oh, all the hardcore people are getting all of this stuff, so I want them too, blah, 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 because they're no-lifers, poop-sockers, blah, blah, blah. Care face right here. Why so serious? Really? Why is it that you seek to homogenize the game like that, you know? So, I do think that clear boundaries have to be put in place, and when those boundaries are put in place, they have to be enforced, because these people deserve to do what they want to do, because it's sanctioned, you know? It's not like saying, hey, I'm on a PvE server and I'm trying to roleplay, why are these guys ruining my experience? It's the other way around. It's like, I am on a RP server, I'm trying to RP, why aren't you guys RPing? Why is that? You know? Personally, in WoW, I'm not too interested in RP. I'm really not, because I'm not too big into the WoW lore. I don't care. I mean, I really don't. I played Warcraft 3 through to its completion. I didn't even bother finishing Throws and Thrones, because it was just too long. And I was like, I don't really care about the story. I know what's going to kind of happen anyway. It's like, ooh, Lich King. Ooh, Arthas. It's Illidan again. Naga all over the place. Woo. Yeah, okay, that's cool. It's kind of cool that you tie the stories together and the quests together, you know, and the missions together with this underlying lore. But to be honest, let's be fair, your lore ain't as good as other people's. You know, it's good, but it's not Warhammer. You know, there are other universes that are way more established. You know, Lord of the Rings would be a prime example. You know, the Tolkien universe, way more established than Warcraft's. So while I could probably see myself RPing in that, and funnily enough, I actually own the Middle-earth role-playing set books, you know, the pen and paper RPGs, so yeah, I have actually RP'd there. Yes, I have Nerd Factor 20, Engage. Yeah. So I could see myself RPing in that. I could see myself RPing in Warhammer, because on Sunday I'm going to start a Dark Heresy game, so I'm going to be doing pen and paper Warhammer 40k, you know. Again, universes I'm incredibly interested in. I've read an awful lot of books, there's an awful lot of literature, there's an awful lot of fluff, you know, published in various books and sources online that you can get into, so RPing in that universe would probably work out pretty well. But RPing in WoW, well, I'm not so sure about that, to be honest, really, you know. It's just not something I've really got into. Some people have, though, and the fact that it is being sanctioned and it is in the game means that it should be protected. It's as simple as that. And the message that I've got for people that do go on RP servers is think long and hard before you actually get on to that server. You know, you might think that it'll be kind of nice, but think about how other people play, because at the end of the day, this is a social game, and if you're going to be antisocial, you can only expect the game to get worse for you. You know, some people take great joy in that kind of thing, in being antisocial bastards, but in reality it comes back and shoots them in the foot, because they're not going to get a guild, they're not going to get an enjoyable experience with other people, they will be an outcast. If you enjoy being an outcast, that's fine, but it's going to come and bite you back in the end, I can pretty much guarantee it. You know, there are very, very few people that actually enjoy being loners and actually enjoy being so misanthropic that they refuse to interact like normal, reasonable human beings with everyone else. So yeah, it was going to come back. When you grow up, when you mature, it's going to come back, it's going to bite you in the ass, and you're going to think, wow, I was a real git back then, wasn't I? You know, I was really, really quite terrible. So yeah, that is my personal opinion on RP. That is my personal opinion on RP in WoW, quite specifically. And to be brutally honest, again, want to see it protected. Blizzard, put your foot down. You know, you're in a position where you can. You might see threats, you know, and you see threats from other games. And yeah, you're right to think that, hey, these guys are going to be serious competition. But I can tell you for a fact, you're going to run into an even worse problem. If WoW enforces its RP policy in a dynamic world, do you really think RPers are going to stick around in WoW? I mean, honestly, you know, hardcore RPers that are not necessarily bound to the World of Warcraft universe, but they're RPing in WoW because it just happens to be the game to do it in at the time, you know. All of their friends are there, so that's where they're there. You know, if they see that WoW has got a more strictly enforced RP policy on RP servers, I don't know about you, but if I was an RPer, I would go there. It wouldn't even matter if I was into the WoW lore or not, because you get into the warlord because the game is designed around that. You know, it kind of forces it down your throat in a way, you know, via the Tome of Knowledge. So if they're going to enforce it, it's going to be more popular. So think about that. You know, think about that when you're looking at your business strategy and saying, well, we're trying to be all things to all men. You can actually keep more players if you put your foot down and you enforce it. Who are you going to lose? Who are you legitimately going to lose if you enforce your RP policy? Answer me that. A couple of trolls, a couple of people who said, well, we're going to roll on an RP server, offer free transfers off. You know, offer free transfers off of RP servers and say, if you don't like it, you've got 2 weeks to get the heck out. Offer guild transfers for people who have rolled there just for a nicer server and say, look, here's a new PvE server. You want a nice server? Make your own nice server. You know, go on this server, go and play PvE or go and play PvP, you know, dependent on which realm you happen to join. If you've joined RP or RP PvP, you know. Transfer them off and say you got a month or so to get out of here, and at this point we're now going to enforce RP policy. So either abide by the rules or else. Think about it. Who are you going to lose, really? What do you have to lose by doing that? I mean, you might make the argument that, hey, enforcing it is a little bit difficult, but how many GMs do you have? You've just opened, like, 3 new GM centers. You're drowning in GMs right now. You know? You get so many frivolous requests. If you can't take RP requests that say, hey, this guy ain't RPing, here's a chat log, go and check it out. You know, warn them about it. If they continue to act that way, then boot them off the server. Say, which server would you like to be transferred to, because you are not playing by the rules here. And be very specific about the rules you establish. Maybe have a look at your RP policy and think, well, is our RP policy actually strong enough? Can we literally actually enforce this? I mean, really, can we? Can we enforce this? Can it be done? Is it specific? You know, is there going to be any doubt as to what we intend people to do on RP servers? Yes or no? If that's the case, and if there are any exceptions, bear in mind, the more exceptions to a rule, the less strong the rule actually is. Be firm, be specific, and give RP players, please give RP players the ability to actually enjoy the game in the way that you intended them to. Because you created RP servers, you gave people the impression that it was going to be an RP server, you gave them a policy that you said they had to abide by, and then you didn't enforce it. What are you doing? I mean, really. Even if only a fraction of your community are actually RPers, a fraction of 11 million is still a lot of people. You know, it really is still a lot of people. And I would really like to see that community actually flourish and be more than what it is. Because if it doesn't, and another game comes along that has a more strictly enforced RP policy, and it's a good game, which War is, then those people are going to leave. I don't want to see these people leave. Some of these people are actually, you know, the coolest people in WoW. You know, they really take the game to a whole new level. They're really careful about what they do. They really get into it more than anyone else. You know, more than anybody else, they actually get into the game and really genuinely enjoy it. And who are you to say that that's not a valid playstyle? Especially if you're the guys who said do it in the first place. So there's my opinion on RP. That was the illusion of choice. And I've got 3 minutes left of the show, so I'd like to give a few shout-outs. So if you want a shout-out, then by all means, email me at themurloc@gmail.com or PM me on IRC. That's irc.mmorc.cam. What the? Yes, you know, after show, you know, late night dunk or on webcam. Try that one again. irc.mmorc.com, #pound WoW Radio. Get in there and PM me on IRC or send me an email if you would like a shout-out today. You know? So, here we go. And also, one last thing. Apparently, someone says that Mythic said they will enforce RP on RP servers. Just bear that in mind, Blizzard, really. Now, here we go. Shout-outs. Yes, indeed, shout-outs coming up. Evening, Total Biscuit. First of all, shout-out to you and the rest of the WC Radio. Have fun at BlizzCon. Next, a shout-out to all my friends, WoW players or not, up here in the north. And to Alexandria and the rest of Frostmourne on Magtheridan EU. Lastly, an angry yell at my nemesis, SU. Hope you are ganked for all eternity. That is by Cheetah Guy. Havesh says, shout-out to Havesh for staying up to 1 a.m. to listen to the show and wish me luck in the advert contest. Yes, those of you who don't know about the advert contest, there's actually a contest to design trailers for shows, and you could win beta keys. So go and check the front page for information on that. The deadline is Sunday, and they'll be announcing the winners on Casually Hardcore. So good luck to all of you who are entering that. We've got some great entries so far. Keep it up. Jinx says, can I get a shout out to Timbermore Grinding? Why is the title Seeker so neat? Jinx of Outland EU, Majors are the shizzle. Yes, well, they're kind of not in beta, unless you spec Frostfire, I must say. Want to give a shout-out to Speedy, that's from Evo. Why? Why do you want to give a shout-out to Speedy? What, for eating 48 million donuts at the last BlizzCon? I mean, good lord, you know, half of our BlizzCon budget has to go to feeding that guy. A shout-out to me, please, for just creating a warlock called Lenin. Lenin? I mean, really, come on. If I get to level 80 with it, I'm going to name his pet Stalin. Oh, you're horrible. I mean, you're horrible. Genocide is so hilarious. That's from Joko, so go gank Joko on whatever server he happens to be on. Now, shout out to the Three Musketeers on Ragnaros US. That's from Paz. Currently playing Horde with Recruit a Friend. Also, BB is a noob, whoever that might be. So, yes, BB is apparently a noob. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. How very unpleasant. Shout out to Trawin and Yazar on Outland EU. And let's have a quick look at the emails just before we go. We've got about 50 seconds left of the show. And again, thank you guys for donating. It's been awesome. I'm going to, you know, throw out one more, you know, one more shout-out. And this shout-out is going to go to Amumor, who says, shout-out to Akuli de Morte, Victor's Honor, and my guild Blood Gods, and all my friends on Bladefist US, and a shout-out for you to voicing the truth in WoW. My name has been Total Biscuit. This has been Blue Please on WoW Radio. Thank you ever so much for donating to the BlizzCon Fund. We are sitting just shy of $100 short of what we need. It's awesome. It's fantastic. You guys are great, and we hope to provide you some top-class coverage from BlizzCon. So, yeah, my name's been Total Biscuit. Coming up next, it's Cadwallian Dunkor with the one and only Wild Things Considered. Go and check out the rest of our shows on WCRadio.com. The archive will be up on the front page a little bit later on. I'm done, folks. Good night, God bless, and enjoy.